द नोबल मंकी। इन अ फॉरेस्ट ग्लेड ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ द रिवर गंगा देयर वॉज अ टॉल शैडी मैंगो ट्री। एवरी ईयर इट बोर बिग जूसी मैंगोज दैट वेयर वेरी स्वीट टू टेस्ट। इन द फॉरेस्ट देयर लिव्ड हंड्रेड्स ऑफ मंकीज विद देयर किंग। द मंकी किंग वॉज बिगर स्ट्रॉन्गर एंड ऑल्सो वाइसर दैन ऑल अदर मंकीज। द मंकीज लव्ड द मैंगो ट्री फॉर इट्स स्प्रेडिंग ब्रांचेस cool shade and delicious fruit. They often played about on the tree and enjoyed eating the tasty mangoes. Their king warned them, "Don't let even a single mango fall into the river. If the current carries it down to the land of men, they will come here in a search of the heavenly fruit and destroy the peace in this land." One day, however, a ripe mango fell into the river and was carried with the flow to the city of Banaras. It was found by a fisherman who had never seen anything like it before. So he presented it to the king. When the king tasted a slice of the fruit, he liked it very much. He shared it with his queen and minister. They all loved its flavor, and in the end, it was decided that a search party should be sent to find the tree that bore such divine fruit. Fleet of rafts sailed up the river carrying many of the countries and the king himself. By and by, the fleet of rafts reached the forest glade on the bank of the river and also found the mango tree laden with fruit. The king and the countries were overjoyed. When the king's men noticed the monkey enjoying the fruit, they were annoyed. They decided to drive them away. Miserably, they sent volleys of arrows to kill the monkeys and to scare them away for good. The monkey king swung to the other side of the river and ordered the others to do the same. "Move quickly, save your lives by vanishing deep into the forest on the other bank," he urged. However, he soon realized that the river stream was too wide for the others to follow. Quick as lightning, he did something very unusual, catching hold of a tall cane and his legs. He swung back to the side where the other monkeys waited. Then he took firm hold of a branch of a tree. This way, he made a bridge across the river with his own strong body. The monkey king then ordered the monkeys to rush to the other side over his own body. The monkeys lost no time in following his command. The monkey's king's body was being trampled upon and bruised and injured by the rushing hordes of monkeys. But he did not waver. He kept a tight hold over the cane and the branch till the last monkey landed safely on the other side. By then, he was badly injured and had lost all his strength. He fell down in a swoon. The king of Banaras was watching this with amazement. He was touched by the bravery and sacrifice of the great monkey king. He asked his men to stop shooting arrows. The unconscious monkey king was gently lifted from the bank of the river and placed on the couch near the king of Banaras. The king tried his best to revive the great ape. After a while, the monkey king slowly opened his eyes. "Why did you sacrifice your life in this way?" said the king of Banaras. "The monkeys are like my children. I am their chief and guide, and it is my duty to protect them. They are now safe, and I die a happy death. I am glad I could do my duty." So saying, the great ape closed his eyes forever. The king of Banaras never forgot the great sacrifice that he had witnessed.